equation. In this equation, let us apply this concept. What is that? T is equal to 0. I will write again, no problem. N2 e to the power lambda 2t, lambda 1 n0 e to the power lambda 2 minus lambda 1 into t divided by lambda 2 minus lambda 1 plus c becomes put t is equal to 0. If you are putting t is equal to 0, what you are going to get? N2 is equal to 0. Therefore, this is equal to 0. Put N2 is equal to 0. 0 into anything is 0. Lambda 1, N0, e to the power, put t is equal to 0 here. Put t is equal to 0. E to the power 0 divided by lambda 2 minus lambda 1. This plus c as it is. What is the value of e to the power of 0? Clear? The value of e to the power of 0 is 1. Therefore, 0 is equal to lambda 1 n0 lambda 2 minus lambda 1 plus c. Shift this one to the other side. Therefore, c is equal to constant of integration. C is equal to minus lambda 1 n0 divided by lambda 2 minus lambda 1. So, we found out what is the constant of integration. Going back to the equation, and I will going to substitute this here, because c value, using the boundary condition, I found out c value. Now I will going to substitute for c. So therefore, n2 e to the power lambda 2t is equal to lambda 1 n0 e to the power lambda 2 minus lambda 1 into t divided by lambda 2 minus lambda 1 c value. This is the c value minus lambda 1 n0 divided by lambda 2 minus lambda 1. Is it correct? Check it out. Follow this. Therefore, N2 e to the power lambda 2t is equal to lambda N0, lambda 1 N0, lambda 1 N0 is constant here now. I will take it as a common factor. This one I will take it as a common factor. Okay. So therefore, lambda 1 n0, lambda 2 minus lambda 1, then remaining thing with bracket that I am writing, e to the power lambda 2 minus lambda 1 into t minus 1. This is minus 1. Because I have taken out this one, remaining thing is 1. Therefore, N2 is equal to how much? E to the power of lambda 2t, I will shift it to the denominator. Okay, before that, I will write one more step, then I will write. E to the power lambda 2t is equal to lambda 1 N0, lambda 2 minus lambda 1 into here. E to the power lambda 2t into e to the power minus lambda 1t minus 1. Follow this. Now I will going to shift this one. e to the power of lambda 2t is there now, I will shift it to the denominator. Bring it to the denominator. Okay, follow this. Hence, you are going to get the answer continuation n2 is equal to lambda 1 n0 lambda 2 minus lambda 1 multiplied by e to the power lambda 2t multiplied by e to the power minus lambda 1t minus 1 whole divided by e to the power lambda 2t. Correct now? Follow this. Now, this e to the power of lambda 2, just you split up into two factors here. Therefore, n2 is equal to lambda 1 n0 multiplied by e to the power lambda 2t divided by e to the power of lambda 2t minus 1 divided by e to the power lambda 2t. This e to the power of lambda 2t get cancelled. Is it right? Therefore, you will be getting n2 is equal to lambda 1 n0 divided by lambda 2 minus lambda 1 multiplied by e to the power minus lambda 1t minus, this goes to numerator, you will get e to the power minus lambda 2t. I will take this one as equation number 1. This is equation number 1. Continuation is there, not yet finished. If you could not be able to understand in a single step or single class, okay, I will stop it here, no problem. But before that, just to go through all these things. Derivation is incomplete, not yet finished. I want to finish it off here, but understand completely. If you understand this completely, then no problem. We can. If you understood all these things, then I will continue. Okay, have I understood up to here? Okay. Follow this. Then, case number one. Equation number one is finished. I will take up case number one. Case one. Secular or permanent equilibrium. Secular or permanent equilibrium. Secular or permanent equilibrium. Secular or permanent equilibrium. Another 5 or 10 minutes that I can cover the derivation, just to see here, understand about this. Secular or permanent equilibrium. Now, let us consider T1 is very much greater than that of T2. Means half life of A, half life of B. Don't forget, lambda and T, these two are inversely proportional to each other. Okay, therefore, I can write lambda 1 is very small when compared to that of lambda 2. I can write a concept here, taken from your second PUC. This is taken from your second PUC, second PU physics, 12th standard. Half life T is equal to 0.693. Divided by lambda. It is present in your second PUC. Just you go through that. This is another derivation. Therefore, half-life and decay constant, these two are inversely proportional to each other. If T1 is larger, lambda 1 is smaller. T2 is smaller, lambda 2 is larger. Using this concept. So, therefore, let us consider T1 is greater than T2, therefore lambda 1 is very small when compared to that of lambda 2. Therefore, I will going to consider lambda 1 approximately taken as 0. Lambda 1 approximately taken as 0. That means to say that lambda 1 is, it can be neglected when compared to lambda 2, that too only in denominator, here only, okay, in denominator, only we are supposed to do all these things here, okay, follow this, lambda 1 I will going to put it as 0, lambda 1 I will going to put it as 0, nothing else, so compared to lambda 2, lambda 1 is very small, therefore I will neglect that. After a very long time interval, let us consider, after a very long time interval, since lambda 2 is very large here, I will take up e to the power minus lambda 2t. This e to the power of minus lambda 2t, I can write that one as e to the power 1 divided by e to the power lambda 2t. That is equal to 1 divided by infinity. That is equal to 0. Approximately, of course. This is approximately equal to this. Let us do the substitution for all these things in equation number 1. Therefore, equation 1 becomes, substitute all these things in equation number 1. N2 is equal to how much? N2 is equal to lambda 1 n naught, lambda 1 n naught, lambda 2 minus 0 into e to the power, this t, you see that lambda 1 is equal to 0, I will put lambda 1 is equal to 0 here, minus this e to the power of minus lambda 2 is equal to 0. Follow this. Okay, therefore, N2 is equal to lambda 1, I will write it here, lambda 1 n naught divided by lambda 2 minus 0 into e to the power, lambda 1 is 0 here, I will write 0, minus sign as it is, minus, this value is equal to 0. I wrote already. But what is the value of e to the power of minus 0? Correct. E to the power of 0 is equal to 1. E to the power of minus 0 is also equal to 1. Therefore, see that. Understand about this concept. Right. Next step. Therefore, n2 is equal to lambda 1 n naught divided by lambda 2 into e to the power of 0 is 1 minus 0. Therefore, n2 is equal to lambda 1 n naught divided by lambda 2. Correct. Understood. Therefore, lambda 1 n naught cross multiplication is equal to n2 into lambda 2. Or lambda 2 into n2, no problem. But I will going to take up your second QC concept again. Okay, this is from second PUC, 12th standard. Don't forget, we have already come across about this. N is equal to N naught into e to the power minus lambda t. For the first element, if I want to write, N1 is equal to N naught into, for A, N naught into e to the power minus lambda 1 into t. Put lambda 1 is equal to 0. Sir, why you are putting lambda 1 is equal to 0? Here, lambda 1 is equal to 0. Therefore, this becomes n1 is equal to n naught into e to the power 0. Therefore, n1 is equal to n naught into, this value is equal to 1. Therefore, n1 is equal to n naught. n1 is equal to n naught. I will substitute this value here. Therefore, lambda 1 n1 is equal to lambda 2 n2. Here, the daughter element N2 is said to be in secular or permanent equilibrium with the parent. Nothing else. What is this meaning? Okay, this shows. This shows that the daughter element, which is the daughter element N2, is said to be in secular or permanent equilibrium with the parent. So go through that. Case number 2 is also there. And you have to draw a graph also for this. means as the radioactivity yes, element A decreases, element B is go on increasing. That you have to show it. So what is that? You have to show like this. This is time interval. This is number of atoms. This is origin O. This is decay. It was N naught. It was very large. It is decaying like this. This is decay. This is production, that is recovery. This is recovery. You have to show it. Okay. Have you understood about this? Is it clear? Case number one is finished. Now another 2 minutes. Case number two, I will go into cover it. Case number two. Case two. This is transient equilibrium. Transient equilibrium. Transient equilibrium. In the case of transient equilibrium here, let us consider lambda 1 is very much lesser than lambda 2. Same thing. Same thing. I think last page it has been written. Lambda 1 less than lambda 2. Same thing. Okay. Same idea. But lambda 1 I will not going to neglect. But lambda 1 is not equal to 0. I will not going to put it as 0. I will not going to make it as 0. Now, after a long time interval, I will consider after a long time interval here, I can consider e to the power minus lambda 2t is approximately equal to 0. Because 1 divided by, I wrote already about this, how we are getting in the previous case, case number 1. Now therefore, equation 1 becomes, let us substitute in equation number 1. Forgotten at this time, the equation number 1. Okay, where it is equation number 1? Equation number 1. N2 is equal to lambda 1 N0 divided by lambda 2 minus lambda 1. Here, you are supposed to do the substitution. If you want, I will write that equation again. Okay, what is that equation? N2 is equal to lambda 1 N0 lambda 2 minus lambda 1 e to the power minus lambda 1 t minus e to the power minus lambda 2 becomes. Okay. Yes, do the substitution for this. Therefore, N2 is equal to substitution. N2 equals lambda 1 N0 lambda 2 minus lambda 1 into this value e to the power, but I will not going to put it as 0, minus lambda 1 into t. This one I will take it as 0. This value is equal to 0. Therefore, N2 is equal to lambda 1 N0 divided by lambda 2 minus lambda 1 e to the power minus lambda 1 into t. But taken from your second PUC. Again I am writing. N1 is equal to n naught into e to the power minus lambda 1 into t. Therefore, I can remove this and I can put n1. Substitute this. Therefore, n2 is equal to lambda 1 n1 divided by lambda 2 minus lambda 1. I will take this n1 to the other side here, denominator, left hand side denominator, I will put it, is equal to lambda 1 divided by lambda 2 minus lambda 1. In this case, both A and B decays, but the ratio remains constant. Okay. In this case, let us write that also. In this case, both A and B decays, but the ratio, what is that? N2 divided by N1. It remains constant. This remains constant. You are supposed to write up to here for 8 marks. This carries 8 marks. 8 marks, one question. One question itself, it carries 8 marks. I will show it. Just from the beginning, I have kept it in order, no problem. All the things, whatever I have written so far, I will show it from the beginning. Once you go through this, this carries 8 marks. It carries 8 marks. Derive the expression for transient and what is that? Permanent equilibrium, secular equilibrium, okay, and transient equilibrium in the case of successive disintegration, it carries 8 marks. First page is over. Second page.